Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm down at Dave Edwards Toyota, and behind me is a 2020 Toyota Corolla LE Hybrid. Huge thanks to them for providing this car for me today. I will have all their information down in the description below. Definitely check out their website. They have a lot of new inventory in stock. This model is finished off in Barcelona red and has an MSRP just over $24,000. Under the hood is a 1.8 liter inline four-cylinder hybrid engine. This can be paired to the CVT transmission or the optional six-speed manual. This engine produces 139 horsepower at 6,100 RPM and 126 pound-feet of torque at 3,900 RPM. It is front-wheel drive, weighs around 3,000 pounds. 0 to 60 can happen in just over 7 seconds with a top speed of 115 miles an hour, and with a fuel capacity of 13.2 gallons, you can expect to see 53 miles per gallon in the city and 52 on the highway. The wheelbase measures 106.3 inches. It has an overall length of 182.3. The width is 60.4 and it has a height of 56.5 inches. Starting up front with the large lower mesh grille, it features hexagon shapes running throughout it, along with piano black trim piece surrounding the entire grille. This has LED headlights and LED daytime running lights. The headlights protrude nicely towards the middle of the car, giving it a really nice look. There's more mesh behind the Toyota badge and blue on the badge itself to indicate this is the hybrid version. There's more contours in the middle section of the bumper, giving it a really nice look. And as we make our way up to the hood, has very clean lines running throughout it. Moving to the side, this features 15 by 6 inch alloy wheels with a double 5-spoke design and 2-tone finish. 4-wheel disc brakes are in all 4 corners. The side mirrors are half body colored and half black on the underside. The hybrid badge is just behind the front tires, and right above that is a distinctive line that runs through the doors, above the door handles, and all the way back to the rear taillights. There's also more black trim around the windows. Down below on the side skirts, there's a nice bulge to give it more of an aggressive look. Overall, this has a really clean looking side profile. And finishing up in the rear with the LED taillights, there's a nice black trim piece running through the middle of the trunk to connect the two. You can see more blue on the Toyota badge. This features a backup camera, there's rear facing fog lights, more black trim on the lower section of the bumper, and on the right side is the single exit exhaust. So that's going to finish up with the exterior walk around on the 2020 Corolla. There are a ton of different options that you can get with this car. Along with the 1.8 liter hybrid engine is a 1.8 liter without the hybrid system. You can also get a 2 liter as well. Plenty of different trim models to get the exact one that you're looking for. I like the Barcelona red on this car specifically. It gives it a really nice look. And now with the key, we'll go ahead and check out the interior. As long as I have the key on me, I'll just place my hand on the door handle and you will hear it automatically unlock. Looking at the door panel now, it's finished off in a two-tone design. There's fabric running along the armrest. You have your side window controls, along with lock and unlock and the adjustments for the side mirrors. There's an aluminum release handle above that. This features a 6-speaker audio sound system. You have cup holder and storage space behind that. Moving inside now, down below is how you pull the trunk release. And then taking a look at the two-tone seats, they have nice silver stitching running along them, good bolstering support. They are manual adjusting. And the front side is the bar to move the seat forward and back, and you have your lumbar and recline behind that. Moving inside now, taking a look at the steering wheel. On the right side, you have all of your cruise control settings, along with mode and tuning for the radio. There's lane keeping assist and steering assist, along with the Toyota safety sense. On the left side, you have Bluetooth controls, along with volume for the radio. There's a back button up top, and all of these will control the center gauge screen. Right in the center is the speedometer, and in the middle of that, using the buttons on the left side of the steering wheel, we can scroll through and look at your distance till empty, along with your MPG. We can scroll down and look at the charging and eco power you're using from the hybrid system. You can turn on and off the lane keeping assist along with cruise control. You can see your normal trip distance and average time you've been in the vehicle. Along with looking at the charge for the battery, scrolling to the right, we can turn on and off all the different standard safety features. On the left side of the steering wheel, you have the fuel cap release along with the automatic headlights, a dimmer switch for the gauges. There's one air vent with some nice aluminum trim running around it. And then as we make our way to the center, this is the 8-inch touchscreen navigation screen. Looking at the home screen, you can see the radio on the top left, the phone is just below that, and then on the far right, you can click on any one of those and it will pull up your battery level, so that way you can view that information and see where your charge is. There's a menu button just below the home button, so you'll see your audio, phone, different apps that you can go into along with your setup, and you can go into your general information like Bluetooth, your voice commands, and things like that. We can click on audio as a shortcut to get to your music, Clicking on map now, you do have to have the Entune app on your phone in order to run the navigation through this screen here. On the right side, you'll see your seek and track for the radio along with a phone button so you can easily get to your phone. There's an apps button just below that. Then you have your tuning for the radio along with power and volume on the left side. Just below that, there's two air vents, and you have a nice digital screen readout for all of your AC controls. The temperature is on the left side, fan speed is on the far right. There's more recirc buttons in the center, along with off. You have where you'd like the air to go. So it's nice to view this screen. You don't have to be in the infotainment system. Beneath that, there's a nice storage cubby spot for anything that you can place there. There's a drive mode button that we can click on. When you do that, it'll toggle between power and eco mode. Traction control is just to the right of that, and then there's an EV mode as well. Moving behind that is the leather-wrapped shifter. Just by pulling on the trigger in the front, we'll put it into reverse. You'll see the backup camera up here. You have three lines to indicate how close you are to an object behind you. The red line is at 12 inches, then you have 24 inches and 36 inches. And then moving back to the shifter, you have drive, obviously, and then the B in the far back is your low-range gear. So anything at slow speeds, you have that option to put it into B. Behind the shifter is the electronic parking brake along with a hold assist feature. There's more piano black surrounding the entire center console. It gives it a really nice look. In the middle is two cup holders. And then as we make our way to the center console, you have a good amount of room in there along with a USB and 12 volt. And then looking at the glove box, definitely have a good amount of storage space. We'll take another look at the interior with the nice two-tone design seats. And then up top, you have all of your dome light switches. Now we'll move on to the rear seats, and of course the door panel is finished off just like up front with more of that fabric on the armrest. You have a little bit of a storage cubby above one speaker. This is a five-seater sedan, so let's go ahead and hop in. Right behind the center console, there's a little cubby storage space for anything that you want to place there. And then talking about legroom now, I have the front seat set at my height 5'10". You can see my shoes easily fit underneath the seat, and I have about 4 or 5 inches in front of my knees, and then I have about 2 or 3 inches above my head. So it's very roomy in the back seats for a smaller vehicle like this. You could easily have two people next to you here. And then we'll take a look at the center armrest. It provides you with two more cup holders. We'll go ahead and take a look out of the rear glass here. The back seats also have a 60-40 split to them as well. So looking at the driver's side here, I'm just gonna push on this latch to the left of the headrest, then we can fold the seat completely down. And you can see just how much more room you have into the back trunk space there. And now moving on to the trunk storage space. There's three ways to open this up. I'm just gonna use the button up underneath. This will reveal 13.1 cubic feet of storage space. Obviously, with these seats folded down, you have plenty more room for anything that you need. I like that on the left and the right, it kind of goes in a little bit so you can fit anything sideways that you would like. And then if we lift the floor mat up, you have a couple tools with a little bit more storage space so you can hide anything there that you need. So for a five-seater sedan, this definitely has plenty of trunk storage space for luggage or groceries, anything like that. Now we can easily close it up. So getting the 2020 Corolla out on the road now, the first thing that I'll go over is the general visibility. For a smaller car like this, you pretty much have a 360 degree view. Forward facing visibility is really good. I like how thin the A-pillars are, and then you have a small glass just underneath them in front of your normal windows on the driver and passenger side. So it makes it really easy to look over, especially on the passenger side. You can easily see in front of both of these side mirrors, so they don't hinder your visibility at all, which is really nice. And then a glance over your left and right shoulder, I have no complaints there. The C-pillars in the back are very minimal, so you can easily see what you're looking at. And then you do have the backup camera again, so for tighter situations, you have that visibility when you're backing up. Now moving on to the comfort. I've put a couple miles on this car so far. I have no complaints with the suspension. It's riding very well. It absorbs bumps smoothly. I like the seating position as well. It gives you a really nice comfortable feel. Steering wheel is in a good spot. You have little notches on both sides, so you have a good grip on the steering wheel as well. And then brakes do a good job bringing it to a stop. We're gonna go ahead and give it a little bit of gas here. I'm just in normal mode right now. And we'll give it about half throttle here. It gets up to speed. It's not super quick, but it has plenty of power to get you up to the speed limit. You don't have to worry about not getting out of your own way there. And that actually was in eco mode, so I'll put it in power mode right now, and we'll do that test again. All right, so giving it some gas in power mode. You can feel it a little bit quicker. It accelerates a little bit quicker than in just eco mode. And then you do have the EV mode. EV mode is purely running off of the hybrid
system or the hybrid motors. You do have to have a certain amount of charge in those batteries in order for that system to work, but you do have the option of just running straight off of the hybrid system, which is how this can get such good MPG both in the city and highway. Moving on to all the interior materials now, everything is very basic, but at the same time, it has a nice interior to it with all the two-tone designs on the seats and the door panel, just gives it more of an upscale look to it. And then if you look at the center console here, there's not too many buttons, nothing's cluttered on the inside. You have a really nice layout with your AC controls and a little digital screen. So that way you don't have to go into the infotainment screen in order to use those. And then this screen is very easy to use. You have hardly any buttons down around the shifter either. So I really like how minimal everything is. It has a good layout to it, very simple and easy to use. The new Corolla also features the TNGA platform. I believe this was introduced in the redesigned Camry, and basically what this does is it increases the rigidity all around the vehicle, so it gives it a much smoother ride than the previous generation. It has a multi-link rear suspension setup, so it basically just gives it a smoother ride. So in my test drive here, I've been able to charge up the battery enough to put it into EV mode. And it looks like EV mode has a certain speed limit to it. I can only activate it under 30 miles an hour. So I'm assuming that this system here is basically for around town, stop and go traffic, as it just deactivated above that 30 miles an hour. So that's very interesting to see. Basically, again, if you're in the city, stop and go traffic, you're able to just rely on the hybrid system itself, giving you the higher MPG that this vehicle is rated at, the 53 and 52. So that is a pretty cool feature to see. For a smaller sedan like this, you definitely have plenty of storage space. You can easily put four other people in here with you. And then surprisingly, you have a good amount of trunk storage space, even with the back seats up. So this is a normal daily driver commuter vehicle. You can put anything in here that you can fit, really. Groceries, luggage, things like that. Well, I think that's going to wrap up my walk around review and test drive in the 2020 Toyota Corolla. Huge thanks again to Dave Edwards Toyota for providing this vehicle for me today. I will have all their information down in the description below. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, smash that subscribe button, and we'll see you all in tomorrow's video.